where do you think does the problem lie, Senator?
Well, una kasi, Karen, the mere fact that we only have term sheets at the moment, di ba? Wala pa tayong supply agreement na pinipirmahan. So for as long as we don't have that supply agreement, the delivery of the vaccine will always be a question. Kaya nga, paulit-ulit kong sinasabi, parang at this point, ang sigurado lang, eh hindi sigurado kung kailan dadating yung bakuna.
In an interview I had with Secretary Galvez a few days ago, he said one of the problems we have under the law is we cannot pay in advance. Is that correct?
Well, isa yun din sa sinasabi nila. But you know, kami naman sa Kongreso, I think we've proven ourselves na pag may hiniling ang executive department, we deliver. You can see that when we passed yung Bayanihan 1 and 2, yung FIST, anything that will help us recover from this pandemic, mabilis pa kami sa alas 5 na magtatrabaho.
Oo. So kumbaga dapat hiningi ng executive na ang down payments, parang prepayments should have been allowed early on.
Yes, in fact when you were discussing the budget last year, they could already parang told us na may ganung requirement.
Oo.
And we could have done a special provision.
Oo, ang dating ba sa'yo, Senator, naghahabol po tayo?
I think, Karen, from day one when we had this problem, lagi tayong reactionary. Hindi, kumbaga, at this point, hindi tayo makahabol dun sa pag-solve natin dito sa problema natin sa COVID-19.
Mm-mm. Okay, ngayon itong 15% na lang ang delivery ng WHO instead of the 20%. I'm not sure if you would have your notes there. Gaano kalaki ang apektado nito, Senator, pagdating po sa taong babakunahan?
Wait, I'm not sure.
Oo,
I don't have. I think that's 20 million shots or
okay.
20 million of the population yung i-vaccinate nila at 20%.
Yes. So ngayon, did the WHO say that they will no longer deliver 20%? It will be 15 or iahabol nila yung 5%?
The statement coming from Secretary Galvez yesterday was 15% na lang.
Oh.
And then we have to pay $84 million for, I think, the remaining 5%.
Yeah.
So hindi na siya 100% free.
Yes, yeah, co-financed. So we are paying $84 million for the remaining 5% if we want the 20% vaccinated.
Yun yung pagkakaintindi ko. Maybe when we continue our deliberation sa Monday, we can discuss this further on the floor.
Okay. All right. Now, in terms of the vaccine rollout, Senator, what are your biggest concerns?
Well, number one, yung vaccine, di ba?
Yeah.
Nakakailang araw na tayo nang kaka-practice, pero wala pa rin yung bakuna. And they can't give us a definite date when it is coming. Well, naririnig namin yung Sinovac. I think there's 600,000 coming. But ang problema with that vaccine, wala pa siyang EUA coming from FDA. And para sa akin, hindi rin naman tama na madaliin natin yung FDA sa trabaho nila just because padating na tong Sinovac vaccine.
Okay. Just recently also, I mean, the WHO recommended AstraZeneca as good for all ages. And yet, Joey Concepcion said recently that AstraZeneca can no longer make additional vaccines. So where does that leave the Philippines in terms of supply? Were you able to tackle this in the hearing? What will the Philippines have? Kumbaga, as a majority of our vaccines, what do we have?
I think it's clear that we will be having Sinovac and then yung Novavax. But I think yung Novavax, hindi pa din ata siya nag-a-apply ng EUA, hindi pa ata tapos yung clinical trials niya abroad. So at the moment, yun yung lumalabas na mga brands na mukhang yun siguradong dadating.
Oo. So okay. So Pfizer, AstraZeneca, Moderna, you believe are only coming in small batches either from WHO or Moderna from the private sector.
And AstraZeneca through the private sector, because the national government did not procure AstraZeneca.
Yeah.
At the moment, they are only in talks with Sinovac and Novavax. Parang Moderna ata, they're not even talking to them kasi medyo mahal yung Moderna.
Oo. Okay.